These tortoise eggs just look like they need a little bit of my help, and if I don't help them out, the tortoises get stuck in there, they get dry up, and they get pass away. We're gonna help this tortoise egg hatch out just a little bit more. A ton of baby sulcata tortoises hatching right here. His head is out, but the rest of his body is kind of stuck right now. All right, you guys, welcome back to Blake's Exotic Inner Ranch. Today, you guys, what I'm gonna show you guys is we have the last clutch of 2019 sulcata eggs hatching here on the ranch, you guys. Comes from a group, adult group, that's over there by Benny. But what I gotta show you guys is there's a tortoise egg. Yeah, it's the end of a storm right now. Of course, it's South Florida, it's raining. Anyways, it's the end of the season, and there's a couple eggs in there that have been sitting there for probably the last couple days, and they just look like they might need a little bit of my help. I've had to help some tortoise eggs before hatch out sometimes, because if there's not enough humidity, or sometimes they just get stuck in it. There's a cup of water in there, and I spray in there every other day, so it should not be the humidity situation. And obviously it wouldn't be, because with all this rain and everything, the garage is really, really humid anyways. But so we're gonna go inside of the garage, you guys, and we're gonna help this tortoise egg hatch out just a little bit more. And when we're over there, you're gonna see there's a bunch of its siblings inside of this container. All of those are just about ready to go outside and go into another container inside the patio to raise up and then get sold off or go to other people around the United States and things of that sort to approved homes only. All right, guys, so normally I don't like to interfere with the tortoise eggs hatching at all, because without a doubt, most of the time they hatch out without any problems at all. But like I was saying just a few seconds ago, these tortoise eggs just look like they need a little bit of my help. And if I don't help them out, I've seen it happen in the past. If I didn't help out, the tortoises get stuck in there, they get dry up, and they get passed away. And that was very, very unfortunate. So if I help them out, they're gonna survive. Now, if they're in the wild, things of that sort, Mother Nature will take its course and they'll just pass away. But because they're in captivity, we humans can go and help out different animals and things of that sort to help them survive. So yes, what I'm gonna do is go over there and help this little baby tortoise survive so that it can live its best life. Even though sulcata tortoises, there is a lot of people of sulcata tortoises. In my opinion, sulcata tortoises are probably one of the best tortoises you can own, as long as you're able to take care of them throughout their whole entire life. If you have a decent sized backyard and you have a dog, I think you can have one tortoise, because these tortoises are just like having a dog. If you can have a dog, you can have a tortoise. That's my opinion, maybe not for everybody, but again, that's just my opinion. And then on top of that, there's many, many states in the United States that are very, very warm that do great for sulcata tortoises. So like I was just saying, that's my opinion with that, and I think having a sulcata tortoise would be probably pretty awesome to have if you have them raising up and you have the yard. Anyways, stop mumbling around over here and let's go inside the garage, and I'm gonna show you guys the babies that are hatching and the one that I need to help out. So let's go do it. All right, you guys, so we're gonna open up this incubator and I'm gonna show you guys the ones that are hatching out. First off, I'll show you up top of here. This is a bunch of tortoise eggs right here that are just hatched out already and ready to go. Like, see, that's one of my buddies' names, Lewis. That was one of his eggs. 1519, just different dates, things of that sort, all have to get thrown out and get thrown away. Incubator has been turned off here at the ranch right now for about a month and a half. The temperatures here in South Florida have skyrocketed a lot. And because my garage is not air conditioned right now or insulated, I have to turn off the incubator, and just, it regulates the temperature without a doubt. It stays at 86 degrees without a doubt every single time. So I turn off the incubator so it doesn't stay hot and it doesn't beep and tell me that it's overdoing too much heat. So it's off right now. But very, very soon, this garage will be getting air conditioning, because some of the dogs will be coming inside of here and having their crates in here. Pretty much Bab and some of her puppies. Anyways, back to tortoises. So let's come over here. I'm gonna show you guys. So we have a ton of baby sulcata tortoises hatching right here. Absolutely adorable, and look at this. One came out right here, and that one is ready to go. So what we're gonna do right now is we're gonna sort through some of these baby tortoises and look through them and see which ones are ready. Like this one right here, still needs probably another day or two to absorb that whole egg yolk put away. Like that one's ready, that one's ready, that one's ready, ready. All right, so what we're gonna do is I'm gonna go grab a container real quick, set it up real quick, and place all the ones that need to be moved out of here that are ready to go. So let me do that real quick and I'll meet you guys back right here in a sec. All right, so we have a fresh container right here with brand new vermiculite right here to go with the ones that are ready to go into the patio. I like to keep each clutch each batch separate from all the other ones, just in case if something goes wrong, as in if one gets sick inside that clutch, I won't have any of those available for the public, things of that sort. And then on top of that, I like to sell the older ones to the public so that these guys will have the chance to make sure that they're ready to go before any of them get sold out, things of that sort. So these are only a couple days old. The ones that I had for sale at the Monster Fish Bash, if you guys were there, those guys are about 3 months old. So I'll wait until these are about a month old before any of these are ready to move and go to their new homes. But so let's open this bad boy back up. Come on, the dogs are right here, Snooki and Fergie, because they're a little nervous with the lightning and thunder right now, but they're all right. Come on. All right, you're right, girls. So right here, this right here is a little solo cup with about half of water, and that helps to make this humidity and stuff in there, and makes a nice perfect temperatures. So let me grab this little guy right here and let's start counting. You guys count on camera while I put these guys inside of here. So we have this one that is ready to go. So that is one right there. This is two right there. We got three, four, five. See, that was not ready yet. I want to keep that one in the incubator for a little long. So that's six, but he's going to stay right now. So there's five right there. That's five. That is six. That's seven. Eight. It's a nice clutch, I ain't gonna lie. Eight, look at that bottom. Eight, nine, 10, 11. All right, look at this right here. That one is definitely not ready to go yet. All that has to get absorbed and put away first. So that'll stay in there for probably another two more days without a problem. So that is, no, that one's gonna stay too. Staying. All right, a couple more to look at. That one's ready. I lost count, so if you guys are counting, put in the comments how many of you guys already saw inside of here. Not ready yet either. All right, so all the old eggs, let me put these guys, put them right up here. You guys stay right there for a second. So I'm gonna grab all the empty eggs and put these guys up here for trash, and then go through here. And there's this one that I've been watching that's been pipping, but it's just doesn't look normal to me, and I really think it might need a little bit of my help. So we're gonna interfere just a little bit, because like I said earlier, humans, us, we like to help animals, and if I don't help this little guy to come out of that egg, I know for a fact that he most likely will not survive. So that is the reason why I'm gonna interfere just a little bit and help it chip off the top a little bit more, because I don't think he's too strong enough to push out. He might not even survive out there once he comes out of the egg, but definitely can help him get out of this egg and then put him over there into the enclosure so he can start eating and things of that sort. Sometimes these mother tortoises lay eggs and the shells are very, very, like really, really thick. I've had that happen with yellowfoots and redfoots before. Not too much with the cicadas, but sometimes it happens. And the egg is just so, so thick that the little baby tortoise can't break through with his little egg tooth. So that is the reason why I'm gonna interfere just a little bit to help this little baby out and help him survive and become a giant tortoise one day and live a lot longer than probably every single one of you guys watching this video right now. But let's grab a few more of these guys out of here and let's try to take that little guy out. All these eggs right here. So the egg that I was talking about that I think would need the help is this one right here. His head is poking out right now. As you guys can see, he's absolutely adorable. But then we have these two extra eggs right here, and I'm pretty sure, hold on, wrong way. I'm gonna keep them in there a little bit longer, but as of right now, I think this thing is completely bad. So I'll leave that one right there. And then let me check this one as well. Same thing, see how all that color in there? You can see there's no darkness. That's pretty much meaning that there's nothing in there at all. It probably just died in early stages of development. And most of the time that happens with my clutches of eggs here with the cicada tortoises. There's always one or two. So always just one egg, what I've noticed from hatching out tortoises from a clutch, that is for the cicadas at least. Once they lay clutches from 20 to 30 to 40, there's only just one egg always that's just not good. It's just infertile. Not sure why, I'm not sure if it happens to everybody. That's always happened with me, and that's what I've always realized for some reason. There's just always one egg. For this clutch, it's been two. But yeah, I don't know, how many tortoises were we at? So if you guys were right, let's see how many of you guys were saying. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We got 12 right there. Let's put that back. 12. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 35 tortoises right here, pretty much ready to go. So that is pretty freaking awesome. Look at this little guy right here, hatching out, half body. Look how awesome that is, you guys. I'll help this little guy out just a little bit. You just take that little piece, throw it up, and then grab this egg right here, and then just lift them up, and throw the egg up there, and put him right back inside of the vermiculite. And as you guys can see, his whole thing is out right now, and all that has to get dried up and goes right back inside. It's pretty freaking awesome. Like, that's process one, two, and then three. It goes all the way in there, and then it completely gets absorbed and goes completely disappear. It's absolutely incredible how Mother Nature works. It's so cool. And what I really think is, how the heck do these tortoises survive in the wild? Pretty much, like, these mothers here in South Florida, they lay nests almost a foot and a half deep. And in Africa, that rock and the dirt and the clay is real, real deep there. So they're dropping them inside the ground, unless they're finding a very, very sandy area, which is probably the case. But if they're not, like here in Florida, in my areas, at least down south, there's so much coral and everything, there's no way these things are coming out of the ground because it's so compact and thick. These babies are so delicate and small, I don't even know how they're strong enough to push out of the dirt, all the rocks, and then, like, come into the earth. Like, I don't even know. It's insane. But that's why I collect my eggs, and I hatch them right here in the incubator without a problem. But here's another one. That's another guy. So the one that I need to help out just a little bit right here is this guy right here. His head is out, but the rest of his body's kind of stuck right now. So I'm just going to help out just a little bit and chip off just the sides just a little teeny bit. Pretty much wait about an hour and then come back and see if he needs any help. And as of right now, see, just doing this, picking him up, gets him going and wiggling a little bit more. I've noticed that as well. So I really don't have to interfere that much, even though I am interfering because I'm picking it up. But as you guys can see, just by lifting it up a little bit, he will start seeing the world without a problem. And there you go. We just help him out just a little bit more. And he just pushes. Look at him. He's saying, "What is going on, buddy?" And look, all in there is that yolk with a, whoa there, girls. All down there is that, what's that called? Egg yolk, yolk sac, whatever you guys want to call it. I call it umbilical cord because, like, mammals, that's what it looks like. But obviously, it's a reptile, so it's a yolk sac. But, yeah, look at this little adorable little guy. Literally hours old, probably just started to hatch out, and as you can see, it's all in there. So I'm not gonna really interfere anymore because I don't want it to bleed or anything of that sort. With chickens and turkeys and things of that sort, animals that lay eggs, with those species of animals, if you don't have water in it, that turkeys, especially the turkeys, they will get stuck to their shell, and you have to help them pritch off a little bit, and you put a little bit of water and they help break off. Sometimes they get stuck, and then look at this. Just happened. I didn't even touch anything. How the heck did that tortoise just go upside down? He's literally upside down in here. Look at him. He's like, what the freak is happening? All right, buddy. Let me flip you back over. There you go. And let me pull that out of there. Throw that up there. Baby tortoises are absolutely amazing. I mean, I love these little baby guys. I've been breeding tortoises now, taking care of tortoises, hatching tortoises, rearing these little guys for about 8 years now since I've lived here on Blake's Exotic Animal Ranch, because before this I lived at another facility, another house, and here I was able to expand very, very large, and now I'm able to produce many different types of turtles and tortoises, which is absolutely awesome. Right here inside of here we have some South American spotted leg wood turtles, some Asian box turtles, we have Central American wood turtles. Down here we have four more eggs of spotted leg wood turtles from one mother, from another mother, and these guys all look absolutely great. They'll start hatching out very, very soon. I mean, really, really cool. The last clutch of redfoot eggs right down here, all these guys, we have seven more eggs ready to go that should be hatching out very, very soon. It's pretty, pretty awesome. But like I said, this whole incubator, if you guys been watching a Blake Exotic Animal Ranch, you guys had those post notifications on, and you guys been subscribed, you guys saw this whole incubator empty, completely filled all the way back up, and now it's on its last little bits of eggs left for the season, and then it starts all back over in just about October, like 2 months, it's gonna start going. They're already starting to breed. So like late October, December, January, Socotra start laying, Redfoot start laying, it's a whole process all over again, and fun happens again here on the ranch. But hopefully by that time, let me close this, guys, so the temperature stays good. Hopefully by that time, you guys, we're able to move this, get all the tortoise stuff, turtle stuff, fish tanks, everything out of here and into of the giant building that we replaced here on the ranch. It's gonna be absolutely amazing. It's just so many cool things are gonna be happening. The farm, the ranch is gonna be really coming together very, very well. And that's why I always tell you guys, put those post notifications on, you guys. Put that little bell right there, put it on, because there's always literally different things happening. There's always problems. There's always obstacles we come across. The biggest obstacle we came across, I mean, everybody came up to me, the Monster Fish Bass, and we're really amazed on how much processes I've been doing. You just gotta keep on climbing, you guys. Can't stop. You always gotta keep your head up and just keep on going, you guys. You can't stop. And yeah, we do it here on the ranch. We got my girl Snooki and Fergie sitting right next to me because they're scared of the electricity. Well, not the electricity, the lightning, just like I am. They know what's up. So the winner for today is Elena. She says, "Oh, Fluffy is so cute. Never seen an albino skunk before." Fluffy, my albino skunk, if you guys didn't see that video, make sure you go check it out right now. Doing absolutely great, living his best life, eating very, very well, drinking very, very well. Actually has been coming up to me without a doubt now and being very, very calm. Make sure you guys put a positive comment down below if you want to get the chance to get shouted out on Blake's Exotic Animal Ranch. Give this video a thumbs up if you guys enjoyed today's video and if you guys learned anything on today's video here at the ranch. And I will see you guys later. Peace out, everybody.